Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Watch Dogs Legion. If you enjoy this video, please download Tinder, but rather than pursuing risky premarital relations, simply educate your matches about my video, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. Welcome to Dystopian London, and a massive thanks to Ubisoft for inviting me to the early capture session. So I load in looking thick, wearing a matching purple tracksuit. Not sure if I'm ready to rob someone at the local train station or attend an intense Zumba class. Let's go. First things first, I've got to build my team of hackers. And the insane thing about this game is you can recruit and play as anyone. Literally every single person in this game has their own abilities, personality, and schedule. The game suggests that I should recruit this girl Leah, but I want to really test this mechanic out properly and find someone completely random. This normal looking woman could be a good recruit. I hope she has a wholesome hobby. Oh my, she manufactures ARs overseas. That's not very Christian of her, so I send an electric shock through her entire body. A truly epic prank, because now she'll probably have an irregular heartbeat and sporadic seizures for the remainder of her now shortened life. While searching for recruits, I notice some Albion guards are giving this civilian a hard time. Albion is a brutal organization that has completely taken control of London. I decide to intervene because I'm actually a great guy in small doses. But as I haven't really learned the controls yet, I end up in an uncoordinated fist fight with these big girls and I decide it's best to bail. Albion has immense wealth, influence, and advanced technology, meaning they have eyes absolutely everywhere. They're almost half as powerful as Jeff Bezos. I steal a vehicle, and despite all the sweet technology around me, I end up driving a car that doesn't even have matching panels. How the heck am I going to impress gorgeous females in this ride? Wait, I'm playing as a female character. Maybe she swings that way. I guess we'll sadly never find out because this car is a fedora on wheels. It's time to find our new member. I spot a chap by the name of Fred Simmons, who is a famous Jamaican celebrity and who apparently gets recognized in public. Say no more, Fred, you're in the team. It's not that easy though, as I'll need to butter him up a bit first. His friend was allegedly killed by Albion, and he wants me to investigate to see if this is actually true. It's honestly pretty exhausting being such a good Samaritan, but somebody has to step up and do what's right, and that somebody is little old me. The hospital records should tell us if Fred's mate is still vaping. The key to infiltrating a locked-down building such as this one is stealth. There's no need for any unnecessary casualties, as we're trying to prove that we are different from Albion. We are the resistance. Unfortunately, and let's be honest, as usual, my cover is blown immediately, and I'm forced to taser some guy in the face several times. At least we've successfully infiltrated the hospital where the patient records are kept, and wow. I'm sure your friend is fine, Fred. This just looks like some kind of minor routine surgery room. In an unexpected turn of events, she is actually alive and is being held hostage in a facility a few blocks away. There's a lot of protests and strikes going on. I wonder if ambulance drivers ever go on strike. Like someone calls up in a panic asking to be saved and they're just like, LOL, not today, champion. Enjoy your fatal coronary spasms. I decide this time to go Rambo with my various tasers, as the matching tracksuit has me feeling pretty alpha. Metaphorically speaking, you don't want to pee on the side of the toilet bowl so it's quiet. You want to aim your stream directly into the water so that even your neighbors know that you're sufficiently hydrated. I proceed to die, which is, yeah, pretty awkward. You don't actually die when you get shot though. You do, however, have to serve some time in prison, just like in real life. Fortunately, Ubisoft hooked me up with a few other characters, so I pick this bearded Malacca who's a secret agent. He has an Aston Martin that shoots rockets and everything, but first we better finish this rescue mission. I remember a few years back I was vibing with this girl and she kept trying to put handcuffs on me, but I wasn't quite ready for that level of intimacy. She playfully chased me around and eventually tackled me to the floor and forced the cuffs on. A few hours later, I sobered up and realized she was a cop and I'd been officially charged for public indecency. It turns out she wasn't even a woman either, it was a man. And that man's name was Barack Obama. Anyway, Fred's mate seems completely fine and untraumatized by this whole ordeal. And hopefully now he will join the crew. I make my way to his location, and it would be rude not to take the Aston Martin. Giving someone a car that shoots heat-seeking missiles is the definition of temptation, and I apparently have pretty weak willpower. I guess this character just didn't get the memo that we're trying to be different from Albion and refrain from using unwarranted violence. I quickly save this guy to help balance the karma scales. You can shoot a good guy and then make amends by shooting a bad guy. As long as people are getting shot, you should be sweet. Let's go chat to Fred. He's super happy we saved his friend, and so he willingly joins. Finally, I can live out my life ambition of being a C-list celebrity. Wait, are YouTubers considered celebrities? I'm not trying to flex, but I have been recognized once outside of a gaming event. It was back when I had about 10,000 subscribers, and a guy at the grocery store asked if I was Modest Pelican. I was like, yes, yes I am. You may kiss my feet. I'm kidding, he was such a legend and I had a great chat to him, it literally made my entire month. The point is, I'm obviously not a celebrity, but now I can be as I vicariously live through Fred. I'm kind of shocked as I was expecting hundreds of beautiful women to swarm me due to the fame. I guess even Big Fred needs a break, and that's why he wore this camouflage jacket. He's hiding from the infatuated cuties and we need to respect that. I've become distracted saving people from the system again instead of trying to be recognized by someone. Then it hits me. I switch to one of the other operatives I have who is a construction worker, and then I find Fred and recognize myself giving him mad hype. This may be the saddest thing I've ever done. This woman can also go invisible using nanotechnology, which is pretty cool. Imagine how easy it would be to watch people use the bathroom, I mean sneak into government facilities and solve the world's greatest problems with this equipment. As her occupation is a construction worker, she can also call in a construction drone that you can fly around. Some will have insane abilities such as this one, or say if you had a lawyer in your team, they could shorten jail sentences when you get arrested. This is actually a great way to see London, as from up here, you can barely tell how violently oppressed everyone is. I actually kind of forgot that this place is under dictatorship, it's just so peaceful up here. No one is whining that they were pulled out of their home and arrested and then beaten up for no reason. Seriously, it's just nice to have some me time, but we better get back to it. This construction site has Albion corruption written all over it. I attempt to dismount my drone, but overjump the railing and land right next to two gangsters. Fortunately, my girl here is a close combat specialist and has a wrench, so I simply beat these two gangsters like they were my kids, I mean what? You can hide bodies using that advanced tech, and I attempt to do this, but accidentally make myself invisible instead. A tactical masterclass. As I'm in uniform, I can walk around this restricted zone, providing I don't do anything suspicious. I make my way into this demountable construction office, and oh my god. Thank the heavens that there's nothing suspicious going on here. For a second there, I thought this was a shady operation, but these respectable people are just on the tools, building a sturdy structure and power to them. I then have an interesting thought. What if I were to recruit one of the Albion senior security guards? Saeed here could give me access to all kinds of restricted areas. He looks like a real people person as well. I run a profile on him, and apparently a colleague of his has some information we may find useful. She's out jogging, and I find and hack her phone. This tells me that Saeed is deep in gambling debt with the mafia. So I guess we've learned that my boy loves having a good time. Hell yeah, dude, a bit of poker, some whiskey, a few Sicilian cigars, my boy here lives large. I follow the trail for quite some time, and eventually his girlfriend tells me that he went to speak to the mafia in person, and she's quite worried. What a worrywart. Anyway, time is of the essence, because if I can save him before they kill the dodgy Malacca, he'll surely join my rebellion. I do find time to stop and admire the city lights though. Again, I can't stress the importance of a good work-life balance and enjoying the little things. Alright, saving Saeed, and I immediately make the mistake of driving a loud car right up to the compound where he's being held. This leads to the situation literally free-falling out of control as I end up in a fight to the death with a bunch of angry gangsters. Next thing I know, I've got my nail gun out and I'm seeing red. I feel as if over the course of this whimsical little adventure we've had, we've really abandoned our non-violent ethos, but hey, a nail gun. That is some good, clean fun for the entire family. After an incredibly long firefight where I almost die several times, I free Saeed, who reluctantly agrees to join our movement as he owes me his life. Now this is hack mode. See, the beauty of playing as an Albion officer is now I can be the one who exploits their position of power. I'm kidding, and wow, my fellow officer accidentally hits me with his baton. Sorry, Chief, but I don't let people hit me unless it's consensual, so we start a classic Albion joust with our batons. This guy is simply a troubled soul though, lashing out at everyone, so I give him a little taser so that he can think about his actions. Damn, I became an Albion officer to blend in, and all of a sudden I'm being run over by cadets. I decide that playtime's over, and I whip out my LMG. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. There's literally no problem a light machine gun can't solve. I decide to play some of the main missions, and it's cool to see what I've already built pay off. I have to infiltrate the Tower of London, and it's far easier for me as I've already gone to the trouble of recruiting Saeed. This allows me to move around the area relatively easily because I have his uniform. I also buy him a fresh red jacket and then steal a double-decker classic London bus. I've never been to England before, and besides talking about Brexit, I assume this is just what you do here to be culturally respectful. I was actually watching another YouTuber I like a few months ago called Jack Frags. He talked about this crazy concept of being able to recruit anyone, and it sounded too good to be true. As far as I can tell, it's more than true, and it's actually quite insane what they've pulled off here, and I'm genuinely so excited to play this game. Don't forget to subscribe so I can be famous like Fred and hopefully get recognized in the street. Thanks for watching, you absolute legends, and a massive thanks to those who support the channel through Patreon. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.